What is long COVID? We've heard so much about it. Australia's been focused on vaccinations and outbreaks, but we sort of see ourselves transitioning now to focusing on the long-term consequences. So tell us, what is long COVID?
Yeah, long COVID itself is an umbrella term that really helps us to understand anybody who's having persistent symptoms after their initial COVID-19 infection. There are individuals, now this ranges, there are individuals who had significant organ damage as a result of their COVID-19 infection and are now having persistent symptoms as we work to rehabilitate them. There are also individuals who are experiencing a novel post-viral syndrome, which has been really challenging to manage and treat effectively. And we're seeing this novel post-viral syndrome in around 10 to 15% of individuals who had COVID, not necessarily hospitalized cases of COVID-19. So this is present in individuals who got quite sick but remained out of the hospital and in some cases only had mild symptoms, but now went on to develop quite severe and debilitating post-viral symptoms.
Mm-hmm. So what are the most common symptoms, David?
The most common symptom that we're seeing is extreme fatigue. So individuals who are experiencing long COVID really can't get through their day. They have extremely debilitating fatigue. In addition to fatigue, we're seeing post-exertional symptom exacerbation, meaning any sort of physical or cognitive or worth mentioning emotional activity can cause symptoms to flare. We see shortness of breath. We see chest pain. We see heart palpitations. We see tingling and pain and numbness down the arms.
How long does long COVID tend to last?
You know, right now it's an open question. I think that I can tell you from our patient reporting, we have individuals who are at 18 months and counting with their long COVID symptoms. We are viewing this as a post-viral condition that does not appear to go away without targeted treatment.
Who's getting hit the hardest by long COVID? Is it older people or children or just everybody?
Right now, it's hard to know who will get long COVID and who won't. I can say that rates of long COVID in children, according to national reporting, seem to be lower than in adults. I can anecdotally confirm that in terms of children who are getting to our clinic, but I think we need to be vigilant in understanding that many children don't have the vocabulary to explain what's going on. It's certainly not what we were worried about with acute COVID, which is older adults with chronic comorbidities. This is something that is hitting young people just as hard as it's hitting anybody else. Mm-hmm. And many of these younger individuals that are being treated, they don't have a significant medical history. They were previously fit and healthy.
So as the director of the Victor Chang Cardiac Research Institute, we're always interested in the effects on cardiac patients. Have you seen any specific problems in people with pre-existing cardiac conditions?
We are certainly seeing cases of myocarditis emerge, pericarditis, in many of our patients with persistent symptoms. And I do believe that, a pre-existing cardiac condition requires a little bit more vigilance, especially even though this represents a small percentage. I would say less than 1% of our cohort are experiencing severe cardiac complications. I think that if you have a pre-existing cardiac condition, it's important to monitor that pre-existing cardiac condition very, very closely, because even though it is quite rare, we certainly are seeing that the virus can cause cardiac inflammation.
In vaccinated versus unvaccinated people, are you tending to see milder long COVID or less long COVID in those that are vaccinated, or how's that working out?
So the data right now on this are extremely spotty. What we can say is that, when we were talking about 10 to 15% of cases getting COVID, the latest data shows that in breakthrough cases, it might be more like 5 to 6%, which is really good news, but it's still very early. Right now, the best way to prevent long COVID is to not get COVID, which means masks, which means social distancing, which means getting the vaccine.